people perceived me as a comedian, I think.
Press the bell icon and never miss an update from Digital Hash.
In the beginning, I just did a few sketches. One was called Emotion Atya Charge, which was like, a slight Delhi accent and things like that. I did that with TVF, and that's the first time I ever worked with them. A few months after that, I was called to do this tiny sketch by Being Indian called Every Delhi Girl in the World, which kind of went viral and stuff. When I was contacted for Permanent Roommates, I had no idea what a web series is. But when I read the script that was given to me for my audition, I loved the script. So that happened in 2014, and after that we did a second season which received even like a warmer welcome. Sorry, I was promoting Dil Jangli at the time when I got called for Apharan, and I met Goldie Sir, Siddharth Sen Gupta, the director. So it's been interesting. I mean, I don't think I put too much thought in it, but just wanted to act and, you know, play a certain kind of characters, and I got to do it via the digital platform, and I couldn't have asked for more. It started with really small sketches, you know, so I didn't think so much that I'll become this or become that. What did end up happening at that time was people perceived me as a comedian, I think, because of that sketch going viral, the Every Delhi Girl in the World. So I started getting a lot of comic roles, which I was happy with if it was written well. But sadly, I did not like anything that was being made. And parallelly, Permanent Roommates, the script came to me, and I loved the script because it was so close to life. And the girl was flawed, the guy was flawed, and yet at the same time they were in love, and it was a very beautiful, very relatable love story. So when that happened, I just wanted to play Tanya. I did not really think it through that, oh, I'll become this and I'll become that. Because I think at that time I didn't even know how big digital will become. I think people's perception of me changed, if I can say so. Earlier, as I said, people thought I was just limited to just comedy, and through Permanent Roommates they got to see something else, and maybe that changed, because then you start getting different kind of offers, kinds of, like, you get a better variety of things. And Siddharth sir did mention it to me last year when he met me for Apharan, that I saw you in Permanent Roommates and that's why I'm calling you, because he liked what I did over there. I loved the fact that it was a dark comedy and very unapologetic. It had a very unexpected ending, and of course Nikhil Bhatt, the director, I absolutely loved him from the word go, the way he narrated the script to me and everything, and the setting and everything. It was all very new for me. Again, it was a funny character, but she had a lot of shades. She was flawed, but at the same time she was strong, and she was likable, but she was also a bit repulsive, so there was so much to it. So I think I was very keen on playing something like that, because till then I was playing Tanya, and Tanya is like, she was a strong-headed girl, and you know, today's girl, urban, and I got to play Sweetie, which was Brijmohan Amarkar. So I was happy with that. It was so contrasting in nature. I have seen TVF from the time they were working out of someone's house. I happened to meet them because Nidhi Singh, who's a very close friend of mine, I was doing a play with her and she knew them. So that's how I formed my association with them. So I think right from the beginning, I had this comfort level with them that I know them. And then after that, they were also doing really good work. So the two of those things came together. With Alt Balaji and also Balaji, the label, I was in school at the time when their serials were really, you know, breaking all TRPs. So knowing Balaji as a brand since then, and then one day you associate with them with such a fantastic script. So I think the difference mainly is that with TV, I still have this certain level of comfort and I can take a certain liberties with them. With Balaji, I was definitely very nervous because they are as big as they are, and I was apprehensive about, you know, I'm such a small fish and these are such big actors, such a big director, such a big production and everything. But they turned out to be as pleasant actually and as warm. I'm from Allahabad. Even though I may not have had an upbringing like my character, but I've heard that language around me a lot till the age of 17, till I moved to Bombay, and so that definitely helped. I had a few references in mind, like of people I had heard. There's this certain person that my mom keeps talking about. She's her aunt and she's no more, but she used to always bring her up and say, you know, she was so devoted to her husband. She was blindly in love with her husband. And I don't know why when I read Ranjana, I thought of her. And then I built on it on my own. And of course, you know, the director helped and Arunuday also contributed a whole lot. So it came from everywhere and became like a little something of its own, yeah. I personally believe very strongly in exercising your own discretion when it comes to what you want to watch and what you don't. People are making only what you're watching. So someone is out there watching it. I don't think there should be a censorship on the digital platform. For all the latest updates on the web entertainment, please log on to digitalhash.com.